My name is Felix Bergenkamp. I did research at the University of Toronto at the Institute for Aerospace Studies, specifically the Dynamic Systems Lab under the supervision of Professor Schellick. And there we really focus on the intersection of machine learning methods with normal control theory. And what we did for my research specifically is we tried to combine robust control methods with learning. So in general, when you have robots, usually they require a model to generate a controller, which then stabilizes the system. The problem is that in general, these models that you base your controllers on are inaccurate. So if you imagine a ground robot driving around, there's always topography that can change, or you can have different surfaces. For example, if you have a controller that models driving on a dry road, and you switch to snowy conditions, it'll be very different. And these model inaccuracies limit how well your controller is going to do. And at the same time, they can even lead to stability issues. So if you try to drive with a controller that learned from, you know, dry conditions and you go to snow, it might even become unstable. So that's what we try to focus on. And there's two basic methods that the community has dealt with to overcome these problems. And one really has been to define a prior uncertainty. So you specify that, you know, your robot could drive on snow or it could drive on sand, and then you try to provide stability guarantees for both. The problem with this is, since you try to stabilize so many things at the same time, that your controller is going to be performing relatively poorly. The alternative has been to say, okay, we start with a poor performing controller that has a wrong model, and then through online learning we observe how the system behaves and we kind of learn how what's going to happen. So one method defines this prior set of a set of systems that could exist, and then stabilizes them all. And the other method kind of starts with the wrong set and then converges to the right one. What we wanted was kind of the best of both worlds, where we start with this big set and where every model is possible. It can be sand or snow. But then through online learning, we kind of learn what's going on and we improve our knowledge of the system. But at no time in the process, we trust it 100%. So our uncertainty decreases. So what we did is we started doing this, and basically I'm not going to go into the details and focus on the high-level idea, so that what we did is we used Gaussian processes to learn these system dynamics from input-output data and fit a function to the model error. And the uncertainty in the Gaussian process allowed us to linearize the system and find linear robust controllers that at the start very robustly, so they stabilize lots of different situations, lots of different conditions in the road, but then they come together and like they realize what the true system is, and they increase their performance as the model, as the certainty about the model increases. So in the video below, you can see that we've actually managed to implement this on a real system. So we implemented this on quad rotors, and you see two controllers being compared. The first one is one that had very little information about the system, and it started out stabilizing this whole set of systems, and we did position control and we wanted a low tracking error. So what you see is we give it a push and it comes back very slowly and carefully. The second video is where we've given the controller time to learn from the system, and it has an idea about how the system behaves. You can see we give it the same push, but it comes back a lot more quickly and it exploits dynamics which is certain about. So that's a rough overview of the research I've been doing. If you're interested in this kind of research, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, or we have exciting YouTube videos, so you can find us there. And yeah, please have a look. Thank you.